And we're back with another episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. Part 57, I believe we're up to. This is the door that was shimmering, and it's not shimmering anymore. So I'm guessing that maybe we couldn't go through it before, but now that we're we own this place pretty much as a stronghold, we can go through. So let's see what's through on the other side. And I don't know, they said there's many levels or something like that. I'm not going to explore them all. Not right
now. Here we are. To think we are so close. Beneath our very feet lie the endless paths built by Ard Nua, the great Angwithan king. Well, up here, this is all Adirin, of course. But should we descend far enough, we will find some real history. To uncover that great king's tomb would be a dream. But it is one of his servants I am after. Gabranos, a powerful mage and a dedicated scholar. A keeper of lore, just as I mean to be.
Gabranos. Interesting.
He was in possession of the Tanvi Orator, or whatever form of it preceded the one we know. I've seen it in ruins, alongside Gabranos' name. Scraps of the same symbols and verses we know in Rauatai. He must have held the words in high regard. Or perhaps he was even the author.
You're always this excitable. You sound very impressed by this Gabranos. They say he held power over the elements. But I'm more interested in his writing. He was a prolific author. I haven't been able to translate everything, but I've seen enough to know that he traveled far and wide. If only we could have met him. What wisdom he could share. But we can follow his example and strive to learn from those around us. Improve upon it. You haven't actually read his writing? Well, not entirely. How could I? If it's a dead language and hardly anyone has translated even a small fraction of it. But what little I can, I have translated. By comparing the symbols in his work to what others have found, I pieced together a phrase from the Tanvi Oratoa. Clear as day. I even gave it to the keeper to check, but she was convinced I'd written it myself. Okay. We can't ask about this phrase? Why does this book matter so much? Rauatai faces troubled times. Once we were a unified people, but that's changing, and the Tanvi Oratoa is at the heart of that. There are those who say that we haven't held to its instruction, that we've allowed ourselves to grow weak and polluted our traditions by welcoming foreigners rather than laying claim to the lands around us, that we must hold to those traditions if we are to make of ourselves a nation to be feared. My brothers would have it so, but we don't need to isolate ourselves to make Rauatai great. I know there's more to the chant. It wasn't created out of sand and water 1,000 years ago, but brought to Rauatai by the Angwithans, by a people that knew the value of alliances and shared their knowledge with us. And with that knowledge, we made Rauatai what it is today. If I can find the original, I can prove it. They'll know the chant is far older than we believed, that the Angwithans favored peace and the trade of knowledge. If we follow in their footsteps, we can make a kingdom just as grand and lasting as theirs. How is one old book going to change the minds of everyone in Rauatai? It's hardly any old text, but I see your point. Kanna looks down at his hands, rubbing the webbing between his fingers with his thumb. It might not convince everyone, but at least it will lend weight to the call for peace. Are you always this excitable? We're on the verge of a great discovery. I wonder at your restraint. Let's start looking, then.
If my sources are correct, Gabranos will have brought the text with him. It will probably be within a library, or a tomb, perhaps. It tends to be one of the two. Let's be off.
I'm not going to explore this whole thing now. I mean, could we? Would we get to a part where we don't,
I shall be quiet as a calm sea, which is not very quiet.
Will we get to a part that we can't advance? Did I not explore that? Guess not. Crossbow. And 39 golden dukes. Goes down. Well, should we explore a little bit of it? Just a little bit. We do need to get to Defiance Bay, after all. But I don't want to let Kana down. Oh, we've got Zorups here. That's funny, it was paused, but that thing was running up.
Eh? How may I help?
Yeah?
Hey.
That's funny how it's paused, but that thing goes back and forth. That shouldn't happen.
Yes?
Eh?
Brave doubt for Lord.
Battle time. Alright, I had her, yeah. Gonna have Aloth stand for a bit. Okay. Oh, is he getting hit? Where is he? Aloth! That was poorly planned out. Might as well hit the guy. Oh wow! Getting bashed up good. Restore some endurance there. Hear all that? That was a lot. That was a big racket. Armor of Faith. Oh, no. Knockdown on this priest. Knockdown on the skirmisher. There's another one back there. Necrotic lance on this thing. Cool. Damn, I missed. I hate that. Fine, magic missiles, or whatever they call them here. Minoletta's minor missile. Cool.
That's it.
They were a bit tough. Bo's Zorup quarterstaff. Common among Zorups who tend to decorate them with skulls. How charming. Moonstones and Zorup tongues. Oh, there's another. Just have everyone stay here.
Lava will be on.
That got your attention, didn't it? Knock down. Same stuff.
Of course.
Of course.
Quickly and quietly.
This crooked effigy has been cobbled together with logs, scaled hides, and bones. A human skull adorns the top. Interesting.
Eh?
Goodies. Did that end right? Oh. I hear that static that bothers me.
Yeah.
Brave Dalphilothili.
Cool. March of the Kamoa. What? We're not sneaking either.
Brave Dalphilothili.
Look at that thing. What's it doing down here? That way. Where'd it go? Should we go in here? Maybe it's fighting the Zorups. There's a dead one in there. This Zorup is lying in a corner of the chamber. Its ribs show starkly beneath its scaly hide, and its breathing is labored, each whistling breath causing obvious discomfort. It doesn't seem to be reacting to your presence. Examine it. You look the creature over. There is a strange discoloration on its skin in several places, but you cannot see anything that would inform you of what ails the Zorup. It was attacked by that worm. Well, let's put it out of its misery. Cut the Zorup's throat. The Zorup barely makes a sound. There is a muted, wet gurgle. And then the creature lies still, blood pooling beneath the withered body. Soon enough, its eyes are glassy, empty of life. Sounds so sad the way they write it. Edar says, "Did what you had to. You work on a farm long enough, you come to understand it. Even if it's never easy." I guess it didn't have anything good on it. snow caps and gold rat shoe. Crap! Oh, we still... We keep not sneaking.
Keeping quiet.
Crap! It's on! It's on! Alright, who's this here? Kanna, okay. Endurance. Aloth. I don't know how tough these things are. Necrotic Lance. And you can switch weapons. Theodas. Let's bounce this amplified thrust off of... Sorry if I'm loud. I can't really have the mic where I want to because it keeps making noise. Yeah, off of Kanna this time. Hope our fighters make their way around.
If thou feel
Oh, nice. Cool. That wasn't bad at all. Of course, it's probably the lowest level dragon. A worm wing. Our first worm wing, guys. Even at their youngest, dragons are dangerous creatures. This is the wing from a worm, already impressive in its span. It's only with 4 copper, though. Okay. Ah, lockpicks. Much needed.
My eyes are peeled.
There's really no need to peel your eyeballs. I mean, seriously. Been pretty lucky so far. Let's save. Zorp Skirmisher. If there's just the one, we might take him down before he even gets to us.
Yeah.
Brave Dalfila.
Not quite. Oh my god! 2 more worms? Azorp and another skirmisher. And that's just what we can see from now on. Glad I just saved, actually. Knockdown. Normal tactics. I'm doing another necrotic lance on this worm. Hopefully we don't miss. That's right, I'm like, we can't rest here yet, but we have camping supplies. Oh, Kanna's getting hit by this flame. 4 worms. Oh my god. Okay. I'm waiting till I can cast this thing. Here. Restore light endurance. Endurance. Restore the endurance. Arcane Assault. Right there. Oh, she still has yet to cast this her spell. That helped. Oh, Aeloth! I didn't want you to run up there to do it. Oh, I forgot Soul Shock. Oh, we got those done, taken care of. Knockdown on this, if it's possible to knock that thing down. Will this work? Prayer against. Wait a second. I'm trying to cast Divine Terror. He still has yet to cast it. Oh, he cast it.
What?
He's still casting it. Okay. Melee. This is. I thought she was Durance for some reason. Chunks!
Lava!
It's not bouncing back at him, is it?
Lava!
Last one.
That's it.
Cool. All these worm wings. Interesting. Okay.
Nice and quiet.
Search for traps over here. Nothing, huh? Oh, Aeloth has. Oh, everyone has something to say. Okay, hunting bow and 152 copper pans. Curled against the inside of this broken shell is a tiny white shape. Only when a tiny toothed maw opens to let out a frightened squeak is it clear that this is a small worm recently hatched. Well, we're definitely picking it up. The party's gained an item, tiny white worm.
Keeping quiet.
Huh. It's a pet! This worm appears to have been the runt of the litter, for it is much smaller than its fellows. For all that, its scales are a beautiful gleaming white, and it seems to be fond of you. Aww, that's cute. That's so cute. I wonder if you can let them roam the stronghold, as it such as it is. Alright guys, what do you want to say? Aeloth seems lost in thought. He flinches when you draw near, sucking a sharp breath through his teeth. I'm not sure how long these little dialogue icons were there, guys. I just noticed them.
What can I do for you?
Are you all right?
Of course. Merely processing some of the unusual things we've seen lately.
I like his voice. His lips twitch into a flat smile.
And if Meowald is to be believed, it would seem you've an uncertain future ahead.
He watches you carefully. I don't know what to think.
Perhaps Defiance Bay holds the answers we need.
Eloth snugs his cloak about his shoulders, glancing at you out of the corner of his eye. I want to discuss something else. Oh, nope. That's it. That's all I need. Edir, however you say it, out with it.
That old watcher. I don't know what I expected, but it sure wasn't that.
You said you had some things you wanted to ask him.
Nah, it's... well, it's kind of embarrassing now. I just got a dumb idea in my head is all. Don't know why I thought it'd work. It's funny. That's probably the first thing I got my hopes up for in... I don't know. Years. At least I got that out of it.
Come on, I don't like suspense.
All right. Guess fair is fair, and you did bring me to see him. Those rumors back in Gilded Vale about my brother, Woden. About how he'd turned against us and fought for Wydwin. Been on my mind for some time now. The thing about Woden was, he always knew what was right, and that's what he'd do. One day he set out to fight for Deerwood against a man claiming to be our god. So I knew that's what I had to do, too. It was right. Hearing claims that he died fighting for Rhaid Saris, that got me worried. Not that he'd chosen the wrong side, but that I had. Didn't seem right what Wydwin had in store, but if he really was Aethys...
He shakes his head.
I thought, maybe this old watcher would know how my brother died. So I could see if it was true. Like he could, I don't know, read it in my soul or something. Use our connection. Told you it was dumb.
That last option is so mean. Telling him he should be embarrassed. I don't think it works quite that way.
Of course, I knew the truth deep down. The Watcher's not psychic. I think I just had this idea, and the idea made me feel a certain way, and I didn't want to lose that.
Really, if I wanted to find out about my brother, I shouldn't be starting with Watchers. I should be starting with Records. So why don't you? Nidor thinks a moment, his lips twisted to one side. He raises his eyebrows. If there was anything written down about it, they'd have it in Defiance Bay. They've got an archive at the palace.
You've done a lot for me already, but if you could see fit to pay that archive a visit with me, well, you know. Knowing my luck, the records clerk will go crazy and try to kill me. I'd feel better with you in there with me.
That's funny. That is appreciated, though. So that gong sound. Oh, Firebrand has enough experience to level up. So, she doesn't have anything to say, but we can level her up. I think this jack-of-all-trades is a bad idea. How about we let her get a survival... and athletics. Bonus knockdown. Grants the fighter an additional use of knockdown per encounter. Or we can take weapon focus. I'm not sure what I'm doing with her. Bloody slaughter.
Mm-hmm.
increases the chance for interrupt. I like that. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna take one-handed style. Done. Our level 4 fighter. And once we come across another story character, I'm probably gonna just bring her back here, or have her return here, or however it works. Okay, so Durance doesn't want to say anything. Kinda wants to talk to us, though.
I confess. I was hoping our meeting with Meyerwald would go a little differently. But then, you have gained an entire keep. I don't think I've seen anyone inherit land that quickly since Kain the Younger read her father's will.
I wish I could have gotten through to him. He was far gone, but don't worry. The past is there that we might learn from it. I'm sure we'll find more answers in Defiance Bay.
It will give you a base from which to go searching, at least. And then, there are secrets beneath the keep yet. With you at the helm, it should be easier to explore the endless paths.
A little variation in the text to dialogue here.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
Yes. Alright, thanks for watching, everyone. Before I advance forward and there's another enemy like right standing over here or something, see you in the next episode, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.